my shoes, walk in my shoes, walk in my shoes. You can never fit on my Sasquatch.
Don't get crossed up, feel like AI when I got the rock.
So what are some tips for new players playing with their favorite team? What are they looking to trade to move up in that draft?
You can get some really good deals at the beginning of the
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
Coming right up, the Bulls taking on the Lakers for the Chicago Bulls. The journey of a new season starts now. The challenges of the past have become fuel to create a path to success. Lakers, Bulls is next, right after this. We are live. It's a Thursday night presentation here on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge is on our sideline. Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. They've got Zach LaVine. Vucevic is out there with DeRozan. And it's Alex Caruso. And it's White in at the point. And for the Lakers, at the guard positions, Russell and Reeves. Down in the block, it's LeBron and Davis. And it's Hachimura in at the small forward. Game one of this great season to come. It's just so great, Clark, to be here with you. How excited are you?
No more off-season talk, guys. I mean, finally, we get to play for real. Some games that count. Let's go. Like me on Christmas morning, I am excited.
It'll be Los Angeles off the tip. Here's Reeves. That one's no good. 0 of 1 to begin the game. And so White will bring it up for Chicago. The Lakers beat them last time when these two teams met in Los Angeles.
Yeah, and their last time out against this club, turnovers really did them in. Just way too many mistakes.
Yeah, sloppy play sabotage. I mean, they'll have to be much more focused this time around.
And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a three-point play. Going to the line for one.
Defensive foul. Alex Caruso.
Lakers shooting their first foul shot of the night.
Yeah, and fairly decent a season ago, about 77% from the line.
Rui Hachimura.
One shot.
And that one falls for Hachimura. LGA for the Bulls, it's been a struggle to find consistency the past few seasons.
It's been a one step forward, one step back kind of situation. They don't need to set their sights on a title yet. Just have to establish that winning culture.
Here's James. He had a 30-point outing their last game against Denver.
And we got to talk about his four steals on the night. That's a complete performance at both ends of the floor.
Now here's LaVine. Shoots over Hachimura. LaVine's shot is off.
Well, the defense refusing to give up anything easy. Love seeing that kind of intensity.
Russell passes to LeBron. Over White. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Vucevic trying to get open. And it's White missing.
It does not get much easier than that, but somehow he came up empty there.
Here's Russell. Rebounded by Vucevic. Bulls have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. And White kicks to DeRozan. The high post shot. And James pulls it down.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that old.
It really doesn't matter what position LeBron is playing. The point, the four or the five, James changes games with his passing ability.
Now here's White. He's coming off a 13-point game against Miami. To the left side wing. 3-on-3. Here's Davis.
Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Those long arms of AD help him on jumpers. He pretty much can't get to a shot because he's so long and extends on it.
And now the first timeout called here for the Bulls. You know, Clark, when he's 100%, Anthony Davis, one of the premier big men in the game.
Hey, I would take that qualifier off of it, Kevin. How about just one of the best players, period? He can pick and pop. He can pick and roll. He can post up. He can do everything offensively and defensively. He's unique as a rim protector with the ability to defend on the perimeter, too.
This break in the game gives us a chance to look at the teams with the most points off turnovers last season. Fourth, the Bulls.
And they turned all those mistakes into points at the other end. That aggressive style really yielding big dividends.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Here's DeRozan. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
DeRozan has that old-school game, a throwback wing. He's not just a three-point chucker, and that makes him a different kind of matchup.
Chicago shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line.
And they shot 81% from the line last season as a team, so you really can't find fault with what they're able to do there.
You know, something you can point to when you're talking about their areas of success last season, free throw shooting.
And the first one drops. We know Greg Elway's challenge recently has been finding the right supporting cast for their stars.
And they're looking for that perfect fit. And sometimes that's all it takes. You know, it's finding those perfect one or two other guys to get you there.
Both free throws good from DeRozan. Hey, Greg, to touch on the Bulls for a moment, defense has been an emphasis for them.
It has, and they went through several years playing subpar D, and it cost them. They began to turn things around a couple seasons ago, and it has served them well. Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
And he makes that one.
And boy, did they need that one. Their first make in the 5 field goal attempts they've had.
Here's LeBron. It's in there. Davis with the assist. James has got his second bucket.
Simply found the open man there because he read the defense. Well done by Davis.
And White kicks to Caruso. Offline with his 3. Los Angeles leading by 7. It up for Davis, and it's slammed in by Davis.
There's no stopping that. AD is too long and strong to bother that alley-oop.
And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, White the pass to Vucevic, and Davis sends it back. Hachimura with it. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Nuggets in Denver.
And when Hachimura is looking to score, it sometimes forces the D to get aggressive. Love the energy.
Second team foul.
And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
And guys, I love the movement. Doing a great job of just getting the ball on a string, creating some opportunities.
In addition to that, they've thrown their weight around inside tonight, too, thumping and bumping in the paint. A lot of their points have come from inside.
first one falls.
Part last season, the Lakers making major trades, shaking up the roster, reforming their team.
Yeah, you know, Kevin, they had four players left from opening night. That was it. Three major trades bringing in new talent, and that makes it difficult to find cohesion. So give L.A. a lot of credit for making that playoff run.
Hachimura hits them both. Bulls trailed by 11. Right side, White over Davis. Reeves with the rebound. And Nikola Vucevic is going to pick up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
Yep, the next one puts them on the line, so they've got to be careful the rest of the way.
Andre Drummond's checked in for the Bulls. Now here is Hachimura. 5 points in the game. Back to Russell. For the three. Offensive rebound. Tries again. Takes the three. They shoot again. Davis. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Andre Drummond picks one up.
There are very few that can handle and battle with Davis inside. I mean, he's got really tremendous strength and agility and a nice touch.
Shooting two.
And that one falls for Anthony Davis. In court for years, the Lakers have been the premier destination for free agents. Think that's still the case now?
I do. I mean, it's still Los Angeles. The history of the Lakers is one of the premier franchises in the league, along with the Celtics. So I think cap room is the driver, though. That's always the great equalizer in this day and age. And I think that helps keep some of the small market teams in the game as well.
Well, he's certainly been on target with the free throws. Such an advantage when your bigs can knock them down from the line.
White, good.
Kobe.
Yeah, attacking the interior is something White does well. He's crafty, and he makes good adjustments against the defense.
Now here's LeBron. To the inside. And it's Russell missing. Bulls trailed by 11. To the middle and stolen by James. Out to the right wing, and it's Davis finishing it off.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over.
And now the NBA's all-time leading scorer. LeBron did something most people thought would never be done.
I'm in that camp, Greg. I tell you, Kareem was my guy. He was my idol as I was growing up. I never thought his record would be surpassed. It just shows you how remarkable LeBron has been in his production, in preparation, in taking care of his body. And this guy is still going strong. That makes him the king.
He's checked in for Kobe White.
And they showed up in terms of free throw shooting. Top five in our league. That was one of the strongest assets for this group last year.
And their field goal percentage speaks to what a patient team they were last season. Good shot selection was certainly the key to their system. Here's LaVine. Anthony Davis with the rebound. Davis has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
and that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
Here's LaVine following the basket by LeBron James, and it's the Lakers on the break. Score the basket. His fourth. He's only missed one of his 5 shots tonight.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
On its way from DeRozan for 2. And they get it back. Here's Drummond and the Bulls with another miss.
The inside just a bit congested for him to get the usual shot he would have with rhythm.
And the dunk by Hachimura.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far.
Now here's LaVine. He has yet to score. Pass to Caruso. They need this. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Here's Davis. Caruso grabs the miss. Bulls trailed by 19. Outside, LaVine. From deep. The rebound by James. And stolen by James. All going up court. And the slam dunk by Russell.
Really seizing the momentum of this game and doing it with a methodical approach.
And, you know, that involves pounding it inside, getting as many points as you can right at the rim. That demoralizes a team.
And it's Drummond missing.
Boy, patrolling the paint well, protecting the rim. That's exactly the kind of defensive effort you need against him.
Yes, that goes in. James has got 10.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
The last 5 trips they've had have ended with a great pass leading to a basket. They're really sharing the sugar.
And while we have a moment, let's check the stats for DeRozan. Last season, he played outstanding. Checking in at about 24 points per. 5 assists and 4 rebounds. It's hard to wrap your head around numbers like these, but that is just what he delivers night in and night out.
You know, it's so easy for us to take him for granted, to get spoiled with what he does. I think we've got to be more appreciative of the kind of impact this man has in every game he plays.
First free throw is good. And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Hayes is checked in for Davis. Torian Prince comes in for Hachimura. Dinwiddie is checked in for Austin Reeves. And Vincent subbed in for Russell. He hits both from the stripe. Now, Dinwiddie. Pass to Vincent. Back to Dinwiddie. LaVine against Prince. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
I tell you, we're taking a look at some real deficiencies defensively. I mean, they've given up 5 straight good looks in the paint.
And it's Drummond missing.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. They're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
And the Bulls with another miss.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
The pass to Dinwiddie. A baseline J, and the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Drummond. Vanderbilt's checked in for the Lakers, then for the Bulls. Patrick Williams, he's checked in for DeRozan. Torrey Craig comes in for LaVine, and it's Carter in for Alex Caruso. Here's Dinwiddie. No scoring in this one. We've got 1:28 left in the first. Here's Craig. Prince with the defensive effort.
And smothered him on that mid-range attempt.
As a defender, he's going to just be a bothersome, worrisome guy, making you miserable all night, a hand in your face on every jumper.
Chicago has gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. Kicks to Carter. 1:03 left here in the first quarter. And there's the bucket from Dosunmu.
He's somebody that's really comfortable carrying the offensive load.
Dinwiddie, left side. Craig pulls it in.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Here's Dosunmu. Vanderbilt with the rebound. Los Angeles leading by 21. Prince in the post. Working on Williams. Williams with the block. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Here's Dosunmu. Traps in the tray. Dosunmu's got 5 now. And Los Angeles guys shooting it officially from the get-go. They're at 52% from the field. And Hayes throws it down.
Chemistry at its best. That unreal alley.
You're right. The pass, the catch, the dunk. All of it perfect.
And it all had to be because that's not nearly as easy as they made it appear.
Outside Carter, and the last shot before the buzzer is off. And so it's LeBron James making things happen for the Los Angeles Lakers. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. And we'll be right back after this. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in a second. And guys, the Lakers are pretty much in control here.
Well, when you control the glass, you control the second chance opportunities on both ends.
And, you know, their rebounding advantage has been glaring, simply outworking them on the boards for that entire first quarter.
And players and coaches want a consistent whistle, Clark. Isn't that harder, though, when minor contact can be called a foul?
Yeah, it is, Kevin, but I do think the officials do a great job. At the NBA level, there's more latitude for physical contact. These are the best players in the world. They're also the most athletic and the strongest players in the world. So giving them room, and I think the officials do a great job of officiating the game the way it should be. And I understand the cry about consistency, but remember now, the officials, much like the players, coaches, and broadcasters, they too are human.
So for Chicago right now, Vucevic is the pivot. Williams is in the other post spot. Kobe White is out there with Carter. And it's Craig in at the three, the small forward. Now here is Davis. After the miss from Vucevic. One-on-one fast break. Here's Williams. And Davis sends it back.
His great length really helps AD defensively.
And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Alderman.
Thank you, Kevin. The Bulls lean in on their veteran core. Zach LaVine said, you just got to be consistent every day and have championship habits. Each and every day, you've got to have a goal in mind and get to that mindset of we're building for something. We've all sacrificed a little bit for the greater good. Kevin?
And that's what we're talking about. That's what it takes. David, thanks. Over to the left wing. Second quarter of action, about a minute and a half played. Hachimura, the pass to Davis. That's another one for him. His fifth in just 7 shots.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
Well, once they recognized the advantage they had inside, it made a lot of sense just to continue to attack that area.
Here's White, following the basket by Anthony Davis. Just 5 to shoot. Basket good.
Patrick Williams.
Williams has got his first bucket of the night.
If you're waiting for him to miss when he's that open, you're going to be in for a long wait.
Here's Russell. Again, Los Angeles.
Time out. Guys, that
was really nice work mixing in this shot. When Russell is squared up and shooting with confidence, which is most of the time, he can bury it.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over.
And one thing you respect about Russell, his ability to get the rock in the hoop.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, he puts points on the board in bunches. No matter what uniform he's wearing, this guy is a legitimate lethal scorer.
James has checked in. Chicago also making some changes. DeMar DeRozan, he's checked in for Williams. Zach LaVine comes in for Torrey Craig. And it's Alex Caruso in for Carter. Now, here's DeRozan. He's coming off a 22-point game against Miami, and it's in there.
Well, it takes unique skills to be able to not be bothered by defensive pressure, and DeMar DeRozan is that kind of guy because he loves taking tough shots, and he makes most of them.
Bounce pass, Davis. Up again, controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
And he's got to find other ways to contribute then, because his shot-making is not happening right now.
And that one's good. Russell.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
And that one, good. DeRozan's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Guys, you remember when DeMar DeRozan first came into the league? He was just really a raw athlete. Now he's a finely tuned offensive juggernaut.
Now here's LeBron. 10 points for him.
And when the score is as lopsided as it is, and you can see they smell blood in the water, that man is going for the jugular.
Well, he only plays one way, and that's full throttle, all day, all the time, cold-blooded and lethal.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole, because he is just not there offensively. Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Here's DeRozan. The Lakers with the rebound. Davis has got 13 rebounds in the game. Class eating. James, no good. Here's Vucevic. He'll bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. White looking around. And the Bulls with another miss. Looking at Los Angeles, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Nuggets in Ball Arena. Davis. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. James has got 3 assists now in this one.
Not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Now here's Caruso. Hasn't made one yet. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got rebound number 15 here tonight.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Chicago has gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. No good that time. Good work defensively by Hachimura. Russell left side. Hachimura against LaVine. Hachimura, no good.
You know, even though it's a point-blank range shot, that's not an easy one, especially when the defense is that tight.
Here's Caruso. And the foul on Rui Hachimura. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his
big group substitution here for the Lakers. Jackson Hayes, he's checked in for Anthony Davis. Torian Prince comes in for Rui Hachimura. Reddish, he's checked in for Austin Reeves. And Vincent subbed in for D'Angelo Russell. The Bulls making a change here as well. Dosunmu's checked in. On the wing, Levine. Over Prince. To end the drought, the Lakers with the rebound. And here's James outside. It's good from long range. LeBron's got 17.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
On the wing, DeRozan. Over LeBron. Great D that time from James.
And smothered him on that mid-range attempt.
As a defender, he's going to just be a bothersome, worrisome guy, making you miserable all night, a hand in your face on every jumper.
And Vucevic pulls it down. Vucevic has got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. And now let's have a look at the teams that were last year's best from the free throw line. Number five, the Bulls.
At the line,
collectively,
the Bulls,
I mean, they had an amazing year at the free throw line. Sometimes free throw shooting can be contagious, and it seemed like everyone on their team had the hot hand.
And that one misses. So for the Bulls, Andre Drummond's checked in for Vucevic, and Terry's subbed in for Alex Caruso. And he's good on the second. Lakers shooting 55% from the floor. We're feeling very confident offensively. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
That's his second.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
And he was dialed in at the line a season ago, 87% from the line.
And guys, if a game was coming down to the wire and an opponent needed to foul, I mean, he was the guy they wanted with the ball in his hands. I mean, shooting the free throws because of his proficiency there.
A free throw drops for Vincent. Now Chicago's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Here's Levine, and it's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
Chicago ball.
Here's Dosunmu. 6 points for him. Pass to Drummond. Taken away by Hayes. Levine against Prince. Reddish. The shot. No good. Good work defensively by Terry. Pass to Dosunmu. Over Vincent, and he gets it to go from the high post. Dosunmu's got 8 points. The Lakers shooting very well, 56% from the floor here in the second quarter. Stolen by Levine. Drummond with it. Guarded now by Prince. And Drummond kicks to Levine. Fires from deep. They get it back.
2 minutes remaining.
And that one's good. Drummond.
2 minutes.
Drummond's got his first 2 points of the night.
There are a few men in the league that attack the glass as well as Drummond does. He's almost unstoppable chasing down second points. He's a tenacious and ferocious offensive rebounder.
Prince outside. Buries the long-range jumper. Prince has got his second basket of the game.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
And the shot goes in.
Mid-range, no problem for Levine. He easily adjusts his shot as needed.
1:19 left in the first half of basketball. Here's Vincent. Here's James. Add another basket to his impressive total. It's his ninth against 12 attempts.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
There's 53 seconds left in the first half of the game. Here's Dosunmu. Another one falls for Chicago.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead.
Pass to Vincent. Now here's Prince. Hayes finds James. 27 seconds left to play in the first half. There's the pass to Vincent. Six to shoot. Again, the Lakers. There's 14 seconds left in the first half. On the wing, DeRozan. Three-pointer. And that comes off the assist by Levine. DeRozan's got 13.
Got to keep the defense honest. DeRozan normally only shoots threes if he's got a clean look.
And giving up some inches inside, but makes up for it with an aggressive style.
Yeah, you know, with that size difference, that's not an easy shot. I mean, I don't care how close to the rim he is, that's a tough shot.
And so it's Los Angeles, leading by a full 31 points at the end of the quarter. They've been playing some inspired defense, giving up very few easy points. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Booch. They had it going the first two quarters. How do you turn that around defensively?
Just got to get one-on-one stops, do a better job helping each other, just, you know, getting whatever they want on that end, and we have to do a better job. And, it's just simple, you know, one-on-one stops. When we help, make sure the guy that helps, he gets help, and just keep rotating. We haven't done a good job with that. We're usually very good with that. So just got to, you know, focus, you know, and come back in the second half ready. Now we can make it a game if we, play better defensively.
Thanks for your time, man. Appreciate it. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show. LeBron James had it going on in the first quarter. He ended up with 19 points, 4 rebounds, and also 3 steals. What'd you think, Kenny, about what we saw from the Lakers?
There was no shortage of dimes on this team, that's for sure. Numerous guys displayed good court vision, moved the ball, led to great shots. They're in full control of this game.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
I know teams love to rely on the three these days, but you gotta know when to get away from them. They didn't, at least throughout the first half. Hopefully they're making the adjustments, but sometimes teams just get stubborn.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. It's been a clinic out there by James.
You just love the patience in that first half. Waited until he got the look he wanted.
Well, you know what, guys? It was all about efficient offense, not rushing things. Taking your time, finding the best shot on every possession.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Down in the block, it's LeBron and Davis. At the guard positions, Russell and Reeves, and it's Hachimura in at the three spot. That's the Laker five. And it's Vucevic missing.
they've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Here's Caruso following the basket by LeBron James.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space, but the defender was right there.
You know, that's a trademark of his defense. Quick to react, close down the shooter, and then affect the shot.
Now here's White, following the miss by Anthony Davis. Caruso, no good.
And out of the gates here in this second half, they have not started well. 0-3.
Here's Reeves, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Caruso. That's his second personal foul. First team
first trip to the line for him here.
At the line for Los Angeles, Austin Reeves.
Two shot.
And he can't get the first one. And he sinks the second. Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. Outside, White. Caruso finds Levine. Sinks the triple.
Zach
Levine's got his second bucket of the night.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
Here's Russell. Rebounded by Vucevic.
Far from an ideal start here. I mean, this half just 1-for-4 so far.
And with an update from the sidelines, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Spencer Dinwiddie has talked about buying into his role. He says you have to have confidence that's borderline irrational, but a perspective that's very realistic. You've got to know who you are. Kevin, he adds that he's not attempting to be a Mount Rushmore-type guy, but a talented player who can help a winning team.
That's a good perspective, David. Thanks for the story. Now here's James. Second shot opportunity. Count that bucket. Davis has got 18 points in the game.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle at their offensive end.
And it's White missing.
Yeah, that's another miss for him. They're behind in this game largely because he shot so poorly.
And Russell gets it to go.
Russell,
8 points for him.
Well, I think the more Russell looks to score from there, guys, the more dangerous he becomes.
Right side, DeRozan. Puts up a three. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Davis is... And so it's Davis. He'll bring the ball up for Los Angeles.
The ball
since the second half started, they've only given up 3 points.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
Vucevic, and he banks in the lane.
Establishes his position with a strong base. You got to box out Vucevic better than that.
From deep, James, a three-pointer is right on target. LeBron got 7 points for the quarter.
A good look there, and he didn't waste it, his second three of the game.
We're always hearing the debate, who is the greatest of all time? Well, Clark, do you think passing Kareem's all-time scoring mark finally puts LeBron out in front?
Kevin, that in and of itself puts LeBron in rarefied air, no doubt. But when you're talking about the greatest player of all time, we all have our opinion. It's just so hard, I think, to effectively debate players across different eras. I just say there have been a ton of great players throughout the history of the game, and LeBron is certainly at the top of the list, no matter when he played.
Los Angeles has gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Here's Russell. Caruso grabs the miss. Chicago's gone 1-4 in three-point shots here in the third. LaVine for three. The shot that time, not on target.
Not a bad look for him on that shot, but it just doesn't seem to be his night tonight.
Takes it inside. Rob. Caruso, the pass to LaVine. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. That one on Davis.
LaVine showing you good effort that time, not allowing the foul to stop him from getting the shot off.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Lakers.
They bullied the defense here in the paint. Look at all of those buckets inside. Just hard to defend in the paint.
And I love the fact they kept the pressure on, really pushing that ball, running it up the floor. I love seeing that. A team staying aggressive even when they're playing well.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Christian Woods checked in for Anthony Davis. And Vanderbilt subbed in for LeBron. Chicago also making some changes. Williams comes in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Carter in for Kobe White. And so he makes both from the line.
You know, when you think of Zach LaVine, his scoring comes to mind immediately. But he also rebounds effectively and passes it pretty good, too.
And, yes, it's good. Hachimura's got nine.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
A second chance effort, and Vucevic with the layup. Vucevic has got four this quarter.
Vucevic possesses what I call a throwback big man game and really is most comfortable operating from this area of the court.
Now here is Hachimura. He's got nine. Russell against Caruso. Down to five on the shot clock. Russell, no luck.
Hey, how about imagining if they were hitting their shots, how big the lead could be? But so far, that's not been the case.
Wood against Caruso. Nice D from Russell.
This is definitely a day he'd like to forget. He just hasn't had the energy or the intensity to get it done out there. He's still scoreless.
Poked loose. In transition, here come the Bulls. It's deflected. Looking to end his cold spell. And the slam dunk by Russell.
Well, I tell you what, such a smooth, tight handle. I mean, especially for a guy with a 6'5 frame and 6'9 wingspan.
Outside Williams, the three. Here's Vucevic, makes it off the glass. He has six.
How about the perseverance there, the extra effort on that offensive glass?
Russell high post, harder on him. Now here is Hachimura, guarded by LaVine. 13 feet away. He clangs that one off the back iron and down it falls.
And a solid shooter from mid-range. Hachimura with textbook fundamentals.
LaVine inside the three-point line. The Lakers with the rebound. Russell's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Passes it to Hachimura. Russell against Carter. 11 feet away. And Vucevic pulls it down. Vucevic has got rebound number 13 with that last one. Pass to Williams. Over Vanderbilt. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line. Williams has got his second bucket tonight. For Los Angeles, they've gone better than 53% from the floor since halftime, shooting 8 of 15. Vucevic with the block.
Get that weak stuff out of here. You can't come weak like that against Vucevic. He's going to send it back at you.
Chalk up two there. Hachimura got 13 points.
And nice job taking what the defenders gave him. But these guys need a gut check right now.
Well, that's exactly the kind of defense that's gotten them into the hole.
And you can see he just caught a glimpse of the open man on the perimeter and immediately got him the basketball.
Pass to Vanderbilt. A minute 42 left in the third quarter. Russell from long range. Again, Russell missing. And so it's Carter who brings the ball up for the Chicago Bulls. And the pass to Williams. From the high post. Rebounded by the Lakers. Hachimura down low. Guarded by Levine. Passes it to Caruso.
Los Angeles foul. Jared Vanderbilt. That's his first personal foul. Second team foul.
This is his first free throw of the game.
And last season, he was successful. 81% of the time when he went to the line, so he didn't waste a lot of opportunities.
Take a break.
And guys, the numbers don't lie. I mean, he was such a reliable presence at the free throw line all throughout last season.
The free throw drops for Caruso. Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Jackson Hayes, he's checked in for Christian Wood. Torian Prince comes in for Vanderbilt. Reddish, he's checked in for Austin Reeves. And Dinwiddie's subbed in for D'Angelo Russell. Chicago also making some changes. Torrey Craig, he's checked in for Levine. And it's Dosunmu in for Javon Carter. Second free throw, no good. Los Angeles has gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Dinwiddie wide open, connects from three-point range.
Could have been much better defense. I mean, you can't give this guy any room to operate.
Now, here's Dosunmu, T right on him. Shoots over Dinwiddie. Dosunmu's shot is off. Los Angeles has gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4-for-9. And Hayes throws it down.
And the pass there floated it up to the precise spot it needed to be.
And no messing around on the finish. He powers it through.
And that's an alley-oop that'll be loop-to-loop all day long on the highlight reel.
It's almost as if there's a lid on the hoop right now. He still hasn't gotten one to fall in the quarter.
Gabe Vincent, he's checked in for Hachimura. Drummond's checked in for Chicago. Terry comes in for Alex Caruso. Los Angeles has gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. Dinwiddie surveying the floor. This one for three. It's Drummond with the rebound. Drummond's got seven rebounds in the game. Offline. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers. Way out in front. Their lead at 38 points as we close out the quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. We'll return shortly. Now let's hear what head coach Billy Donovan was reviewing with his team in the huddle.
You should never get beat like that in transition when they throw the ball. Those points add up right now. Let's be locked in and focused right now.
Billy Donovan, as you can tell, not too happy, failing to get back on defense, a major sin in the game of basketball, especially from his standpoint.
Yeah, and any time you get severely out-hustled, you're going to hear about it from your coach. And you should if he's worth anything.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. So for Chicago right now, Torrey Craig is out there with Williams. Then it's Terry. Then there's Dosunmu. And it's Drummond in at the center. Williams with the block. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Williams. Now off the inbound, and the layup is up and in.
The assist.
The Bulls should just 26% out there. A terrible showing from an offense capable of much better. And here is Dosunmu. Down low. Here's Drummond. It's rebounded by Hayes. Hayes has got rebound number 5 here tonight. Inside, Prince. And the dunk by Prince.
Prince can really elevate now. He plays much bigger than 6'7", and we just saw an example of that there.
Terry kicks to Williams from downtown. Vincent with the rebound.
That's excellent defense right there on the perimeter.
There's the drive. Hayes the pass to Vincent. Good D by Drummond. And it's Drummond with the ball. He'll bring it up for Chicago. Terry dishes to Williams. Pass to Dosunmu. There's the three. Goes back up. And the basket is good. And he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
Really good sign for him. The work they've done on the offensive glass this half, paying dividends.
So, Clark, we know you're very familiar with the college game. How do you think the one-and-done rule has worked out so far?
You know, not as it was intended to, Kevin. I mean, in some ways, the chance to see guys like Durant and others play in college for a year was better than not having them there. But I think it's also created this expectation that if you're not a one and done, that you've somehow failed. And that's detrimental to the psyche of young players.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. It doesn't go for him. Good work defensively by Terry.
It's really surprising that they're up at this point, given that he's struggled so mightily.
They get it again. Williams can't get it to go. Lakers have gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Dinwiddie with the bucket.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Hands it from downtown. Dinwiddie's got 5 points now in the quarter.
He wasn't able to get his name in the score sheet in the first half. But he looks like he's starting to find his comfort zone here.
And the basket is good.
Patrick Williams.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. Pass to Wood. Now, here's Reddish. He's guarded by Williams. Now the pass to Vincent. The tray. And another three for the Lakers.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Certainly. I mean, they saw a weakness in the perimeter defense and took advantage of it.
Now here is Carter. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. And that one's good. Drummond.
And you know, Drummond has no problem playing through contact. He excels at using that strong body of his to fight through contact and finish.
Vincent the pass to Vanderbilt. Passes it to Wood. Over Drummond. It's Drummond with the rebound.
I think in that situation, that was a nice try to create some space for himself with the fadeaway.
Carter inside the three-point line. The second effort. And it's Drummond missing. L.A. has gone 2 for 2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Here's Vincent. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got his third assist on the night. Chicago's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Here's Williams. They get the rebound. Drummond can't cash in from close range. Here's Los Angeles now. They're on a 14-6 run. Here he goes. Vincent misses. The Bulls shooting a putrid 25% from the field. Poor shot selection all around. Dinwiddie with the steal. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession. Chicago making a switch here. DeRozan's checked in.
DeMar DeRozan.
Defense! Drummond working against Wood. DeRozan surveying the D. That's good from 17 feet away.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
I love that mid-range shot. It's definitely giving the defender something extra to think about.
And there's another turnover by the Lakers.
Chicago ball.
And here are the Bulls now. Carter kicks to DeRozan. Over Reddish. And DeMar DeRozan, the bucket on the assist from Carter. DeRozan's got 4 points in the quarter.
You know, even when you know what DeRozan's going to do, you can't stop it.
Dinwiddie outside. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And he sure can get off the floor.
He's one of the best in the business, absolutely.
Boy, he makes it look easy. He is an absolutely imposing finisher around the rim.
Here's Drummond. Good D by Wood. L.A. has gone 6 of 12 from outside. A very nice 50% mark, shooting the three ball well.
The defense of DeRozan, vastly underrated.
Carter finds Drummond. Tries again. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Wood's got his 6th rebound on the night. Reddish the pass to Dinwiddie. We are looking around the NBA, Greg. It feels like there's more parity among teams than ever before.
No dominant team has been the favorite every year. And that can all change, though, in a heartbeat. Every so often, a dynasty can be born out of nothing.
The offensive rebound. And it's Drummond missing.
I wonder if switching baskets really threw him off. I mean, because he can't get anything to fall this half.
And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
That's his first personal foul. First team foul. At the line for the Lakers, Spencer Dinwiddie. 2 shots.
That free throw, no good. Hayes, he's checked in for the Lakers. Good on the second free throw. Here's DeRozan. Over Vincent. DeRozan gets the bucket. DeRozan's got 21 in the game.
Such a great rhythm watching DeRozan shoot. I mean, that jump shot of his, silky smooth.
Here's Vincent, defended by Carter. Hayes with it. Here's Dinwiddie. Another shot, and 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. Andre Drummond picks one up.
Personal foul. Second team foul. At the line for Los Angeles, Jackson Hayes.
2-2.
Free throw good from Hayes. And GA starting next season, some big repeat penalties for teams well over the cap. That draft pick penalty is especially tough.
Yeah, I mean, if a team is over that $17.5 million mark twice in a 4-year span, their first round draft pick falls to the end of the first round, that'll sting.
And he makes the first but misses the second. And so it's Drummond with it. He'll bring it up for the Bulls. DeRozan, and he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
That's his first shot. DeRozan is deceptive in his height and quickness, so I think it makes him hard to guard, especially from this area.
Shooting for Chicago, DeMar DeRozan. taking two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
No good on the free throw.
Here in this second half, they've gone cold from the line, and I think it's hurting their chances.
And the second free throw, good. And Greg, one of the finer points of the new collective bargaining agreement, players in the G League Ignite or overseas no longer automatically entering the NBA draft when they turn 19.
Yeah, it makes sense. You think about players in college, they choose when to enter the draft. So only right to give pros that same amount of time.
Yeah, the D has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the court.
Here's Vincent, defended by Carter. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Javon Carter. That's his first foul. And the NBA's new CBA cracking down on the top spending teams, Greg, but also the bottom spending teams.
Yeah, before, teams had until the trade deadline to hit the minimum salary floor. Now they've got to be there before they lose out on luxury tax distributions, which could end up in the millions. And the definition of teamwork right there on that alley-oop.
And, Greg, what about the finish? Bringing it down with some thunder.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I think the pass was even better. I mean, that was room service delivery at its finest.
Here's Reddish after the Bulls pick up two. Pass to Vincent. Contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
Yeah, great concentration there. Hung in there. He didn't let that contact throw him off at all. Stayed focused on the rim. Knew he was going to get hit, and still was able to finish.
Gabe Vincent.
Free throw drops for Vincent. 1:49 left to play in the final quarter. Terry outside. Over Reddish. Here's another rebound. He hauls in his 20th rebound.
Dominating the glass.
Los Angeles has gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter.
Had their fingerprints all over this matchup tonight. Just an impressive victory
for the Lakers.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought. An all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
And you could tell they were ready for this one today, guys. There was something extra on the line, and they wanted it.
I know exactly what you're referring to. I mean, with this victory, they'll get the edge in the season series by taking two of their three meetings.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Anthony Davis.
He did all the dirty work that they needed, clearing out space underneath and securing rebounds.
Here is Carter following the basket by Cam Reddish.
Having a hand up in your face makes such a difference to a shooter.
And, you know, he's a guy who knows how to defend the three-point shot. He's not going to just give it to you. He's going to make you earn it.
Pass to Prince. Wood against Drummond. Shot clock at 5. Launches a 3. Here's Hayes. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
Mm-hmm. now Hayes. And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. They poured it out tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home, no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, LeBron. You got after it on defense. You look motivated.
You know, I heard it all from, you know, is this the last that we've seen of LeBron and the fashion that he plays, and then defensively, you know, he's not very good defensively, but you can't single me out. You know, it will never be a possession where a coach or a teammate or a player on the opposing team will single me out defensively because I'm in tune with that side as well. So, you know, we got a lot of guys that play the defensive side, and it's important for me to be on that side as well and take that challenge just as much as the offensive end.
Seems like you took some words to heart, man. Thanks. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. So long.